So nevertheless, this particular signal is likely to be a human interference, perhaps. But do you find Proxima B interesting? Or the more general question is, do you think we humans will venture out into outside our solar system and potentially colonize other habitable planets?
Actually, I am involved in a project whose goal is to develop the technology that would allow us to leave the solar system and visit the nearest stars. And that is called the Starshot. In May 2015, an entrepreneur from Silicon Valley, Yuri Milner, came to my office at Harvard and said, would you be interested in leading a project that would do that in our lifetime? Because as we discussed before, to traverse those distances, you know, with existing rockets would take tens of thousands of years. And, you know, that's too long. You know, for example, to get to Proxima Centauri with the kind of spacecrafts that we already sent, like New Horizons or Voyager 1, Voyager 2, you needed to send them when the first humans left Africa. So that they would arrive there now.
Yes.
And, you know, that's a long time to wait. So Yuri wanted to do it within our lifetime.
Yes.
10, 20 years, meaning it has to move at a fraction of the speed of light. So can we send a spacecraft that would be moving at a fraction of the speed of light? And I said, let me look into that for 6 months. And with my students and postdocs, we arrived to the conclusion that the only technology that can do that is the light sail technology. Where
can you explain it?
You basically produce a very powerful laser beam on Earth, so you can collect sunlight with photovoltaic cells or whatever, and then convert it into stored energy, and then produce a very powerful laser beam that is 100 gigawatt, and focus it on a sail in space that is roughly the size of a person, a couple of meters or a few meters, that weighs only a gram or a few grams, very thin. And through the math, you can show that you can propel such a sail. If you shine on it for a few minutes, it will traverse a distance that is five times the distance to the moon, and it will get to a fifth of the speed of light.
Sounds crazy, but I've talked to a bunch of people and they're like, I know it sounds crazy, but it's actually, it will work. This well, is one of those, it's just beautiful. I mean, this is science.
And the point is, people didn't get excited about space since the Apollo era. And it's about time, you know, for us to go into space.